This video will explain how to determine the percentage of each fraction, and we'll look at two different examples. The one on the left hand side is coarse grain soil. The one on the right hand side, it's a soil that has fine particles. In soil mechanics course, we deal with material that has a combination of different fractions, including gravel, sand, silt, and clay. And we should remember the boundaries between these fractions. There are different classification systems. This one is a unified soil classification system, a British system, and Australian system. In this example, we're going to use Australian system. And you will see that the boundary between sand and gravel is 2.36 millimeters. The boundary between sand and silt is defined as 0.075 millimeters. And the particles that are finer, smaller than 0.002 millimeters, will be clay. So now let's look at the first example on the left-hand side. And let's try to determine the amount percentage of each fraction. And we'll start with the gravel and sand. We're going to find the boundary, which is 2.36. It's somewhere here. So if we draw a line like as I did, we'll see that everything on the right hand side is going to be gravel, and on the left hand side is going to be sand. And now let's draw another boundary between sand and silt. It's 0.075. It's exactly where the last point of the curve is. So we're going to say that everything here on the left is going to be fines. For this case, we don't know how much silt and clay in this soil, so we just call it fines. So now let's calculate the percentage of each fraction, and we'll start again with gravel. We'll see where this curve crosses the axis, where we have percentage finer, and we'll see that it will be about somewhere here, which is approximately 32%. This means that 32% of the soil is actually finer than this size, 2.36. This also means that 68% of the soil is actually greater than this size. So this will imply that we have gravel, 100% of the soil, minus 32% that is finer than the sieve size 2.36, will give us 68%. Okay, now let's move to the next boundary. And we know that out of 32%, that actually finer than 2.36 millimeters size, then we will see that here, last point of the curve will give us about 1%. So this means that only 1% of this soil is finer or smaller than the size of 0.075 millimeters. So all these particles, which are fines, will be only 1%. And then we can write that for sand, we started with 32% and we ended at 1%. So what I do, I just look at the percentage passing for each boundary. The boundary on the right hand side where we have the top size of the sand, and boundary on the left hand side here when we already have silt. So silt to clay, 31%. And this one, fines, I'm going to use F for fines, will be 1%. Again, we don't know if it's silt to clay because there is not enough information to make this decision. Okay, now let's look at the second example. In this case, you will see that we have different ranges. Our curve goes all the way to the size of 0.002 millimeters. So this actually implies that this soil has fine particles compared to the example on the left-hand side, where all the data finish here at this point at 0.075 millimeters. Okay, now let's do the same procedure and let's determine how much gravel, sand, and fines we have. And in this case, because we have more data about fines, we can also divide it into silt and clay. So let's do it together. Again, we'll start with the first boundary, which is 2.36 millimeters. And this is going to be this line. So all the material that we have on the right-hand side will be gravel. And let's find how much sand we have. So we're going to look at the second boundary between sand and silt. It's 0.075 millimeters. And this is going to be the second boundary. So this is, we have sand. So now we can also determine the boundary between silt and clay. And in our case, when we use Australian standard, it's 0.002 millimeters, it's here. So here we have silt, and for silt we use symbol M. And everything that is left here is going to be clay. See? Okay. Now let's just calculate the amount of each fraction. Again, we'll start with 100% here. Then soil goes through the sieves, and then we'll see that it's about 75% will be finer than the sieve size of 2.36, which means that gravel is the part that is actually remains in the sieve, which is doesn't pass through the sieve. And if 75% are passing through the sieve, it means that the gravel is 25%. Okay, so now let's look at the sand. We know that it starts from 75% finer, and then it goes to this point, which is, I would say, 35%. That's the boundary between sand and silt. So 75 minus 35. So that's what we have for sand. Will give us 40%. And now let's look at the final point when we have the boundary with clay. So this point will give us approximately 12%. So in this case, we write that silt, it's it will start from 35%, so finer, and goes all the way to 12, which will give us 23%. And the rest, what is left, it's 12% will be clay. So we don't have any information after this point. So typically, we the test that we perform, it's only good enough to get information of the size to 0.002 millimeters.